Hello viewers, and welcome to another episode of the Talk About Jesus People's program. I'm your host, Rachel Graham. Today, we are in the Trinityville district, located in the beautiful parish of St. Thomas, Trinityville Seventh-day Adventist Church to be exact. Present here today is Elder Victor Hill, who is the oldest member of this church. We will be talking to Elder Victor Hill in a few minutes. Let's go. Happy Sabbath, Elder Hill.
A pleasant and happy return.
The Seaforth SDA TV is very blessed to have you as our guest today. I know you had a special birthday celebration last August. Tell us what it was like.
I want to tell you it was really lovely, you know. It more than I can express. I want to really magnify Sister Williams, because she's a person that really consider me, and to have my birthday. And it was pleasant. There were pastors and well-wishers and brethren. And it was wonderful, man. I felt so good to know that I live to God, and I could be recommended from the brethren and well-wishers of my life of living.
Thank you, Elder Hill. I understand that you weren't baptized here in Trinityville. Tell us, where were you baptized?
Well, I want to tell you that I baptized over in Portland. And I want to tell you that the pastor was Neymar. But the time when I baptized, I never so serious about the time of baptism. So then, I really don't remember the definite time I was baptized. But I know it's over Portland.
Elder Hill, tell me a little about your life before you came to Trinityville.
Well, my life, as I told you, I was born in St. Mary. Grew up in Portland and naturalized in St. Thomas. And my life, grown up, my parents weren't really on such a good background financially, but I really work hard, and I think after years I would like to love Jesus. And I started out to think about Jesus. No one really come to me and tell me that I should accept the message. But I took it on my shoulder and I went to the church. And I was treated very, very good. It was lovely. Can't desire better. And I decided from there, from the church, that I should be a member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. And so I was baptized by a pastor from Somal Island, Neymar, H.E. Neymar. And so I accepted the message, which I don't remember the time that I accepted the message, but I went away to St. Mary to do some carpooting work. A cardinal, the Spirit led me. And after I over there, I do a successful work, and I came over to this parish, and I get married over this parish, and still become a member of this St. Adventist Church.
You also got married right here in Trinityville to one of the most active church workers from the Whitehall Seventh-day Adventist Church. Tell me, when were you married and how was it?
I'm saying that my marriage life was very successful. And I'm married to a elderly woman, so I did not get any children. So it was successful, and I married 1951, and my wife died 1983.
Thank you, Elder. Now, Elder, you belong to a Seventh-day Adventist church that is a strong part of the Adventist Foundation in this island, Jamaica. Tell me how you know it. When was Trinityville Seventh-day Adventist started and how?
Well, to be frank, you know, I was a colporter. They received me into the church as a member. But when I came from Portland, some of the leaders, just when I came, they just moved out a week before, some of the leaders. But I can say I have seen one brother, he died now, Brother Brown, and had a brethren, you know, that we moved together until now.
I know you have served in many areas of the church in many capacities. Tell me, sir, what were some of the major challenges you faced while serving in these capacities?
Well, you know, it wasn't any extra challenge. I served as a treasurer. I served as a leader, and I was ordained after a considerable time, and so then time and again the church kind of what I should say, it get down, but I still hold on. And still hold on until it build up. I never leave. And I still hold on and continue the work. There were brethren that there are people that came in, and the church started to grow by the mercies of God. And so I am in the church from that time until now.
I am the resurrection and the life. Even though you are dead, he that believeth in me shall have life. Today we try to have life in anyhow, but to have life in Jesus Christ, we have something. Today Christ is still living. His resurrection. He's our pilot, he's our shepherd, and he's everything to the world.
I know that you have served as an elder in this church. Tell us, how long have you served as an elder?
Over 50 years.
Wow, that's very long. In regards to training, how important do you think is training for church growth?
Training is very, very good. And it's very effective in the last days that we are living. But without training, the younger ones cannot survive. They have to have good training, not like in time past. Because we recognize that the enemy is on the line, and extra now, so they have to have good training if they should really hold on to the faith.
Under your watch as a church elder, you would have seen hundreds of souls come to Jesus to be baptized. How does this make you feel to be a part of that holy experience?
Well, I want to tell you, it may be more than 100, because I remember that personally I went out on a cottage meeting and I long years after, when I went back at the same place, the person, somebody say, "Who is that, Brother Hill?" And I couldn't recognize. When I asked the individual, I said, who are you? He said, you don't remember the little girl that always run about and they talk to her and who's even maybe? So when I asked her, "I'm married no one in Kingston. And I'm a Sunday Adventist," and you know, so it makes me feel like me reach Beulah Land.
Amen indeed. My final question to you, Elder Hill. What is your hope for the church in these last days that we are living in?
Well, my hope for the church really is victory. The church, in spite of the challenges, but the church is moving, conquering and to conquer. The church cannot be defeated. The Seventh-day Adventist Church, the true church.
Amen. To God be the glory for that. Thank you very much, Elder Victor Hill. This was indeed a rich experience to share.
Welcome to VOP, Voice of the People. I'm your host, Stasha Morrison. Today, we will be talking to a few members of the Trinityville SDA Church about Brother Hill, which is the oldest member of the church. Let's go! With me is Sister Williams, a member of the Trinityville SDA Church. Now, Sister Williams, can you tell me how long have you known Brother Hill and what has your experience with him been like?
I've known Brother Hill over 50 years, but we are brother and sister over 40 years. And Brother Hill is a father, a grandfather, and a nice person.
With me is Brother Leon. Now, Brother Leon, can you tell us how long you have known Brother Hill and what has your experience with him been like?
Well, I've known Brother Hill from ever since I was young. And my experience with Brother Hill, well, He's a very generous person, always helpful, right day time. He's always on the ball helping. So I can say he's a really strong gentleman, even though he's in his 90s, but I can say that, yes, he's a very good gentleman.
Here with me is Brother Baxter. Now, Brother Baxter, can you tell me how long you have known Brother Hill and what has your experience with him been like?
Well, actually, I have known Brother Hill for the past 40 years, even before I became a Christian. But actually, when I became a Christian, I was able to know much about Brother Hill. What I found out that he's a good Christian man. He's a person who loves to evangelize, and he's serving the different areas of the church, like personal ministry and first elder and some of those important offices in the church.
And then we have differences because, disagreement, but we disagree to agree, right? And I've seen Brother Hill now as our father and grandfather in the church. He's the oldest in the church, and then we have to take care of him.
I think he's a good Christian, and I'm very happy to know that he could be consistent in his relationship with God and with the church, even up to this point in mind, point in time. I think he's a good person, yes. He was married, his first wife died, and he married a second time. Unfortunately, he was not able to get a child of his own. But all of us in the church, we are his children in a spiritual sense, yes.
Okay, thank you, and have yourself a wonderful Sabbath.
Thank you for joining us for another episode of the Talk About Jesus People's Program. Until next time, I'm Rochelle.
I'm Stasha.
Goodbye.
May the Lord have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon you as you cling to Jesus Christ. Surely, Daniel, God will surely deliver. And if he delivered Daniel, he will deliver you and me from the lion's den. So may the Lord have mercy. May the Lord look down upon us with his eyes of pity. We are living in a tremendous days. But while we have Jesus, we have everything. We will see ourselves through. May the Lord bless you and keep you. My prayer in Jesus' name.